What springs to your mind first when someone mentions the most protracted and bloody urban battle of World War II? If it's the Battle of Shanghai, I can probably guess where you're from. Sadly, the Sino-Japanese front isn't Panzer Corps' strong suit, so we're gonna talk about Stalingrad, which it smothers with attention as the city appears in a whooping 5 scenarios in 3 campaigns. In the original Panzer Corps, in the Soviet Corps, and horrifyingly, the 1942 Grand Campaign episode. Quite appropriately, most of them present a painful challenge to the player, up to the point of abandoning the game altogether, let alone any hope of decisive or even marginal victory, and thus, this might be as good a time as any to look for ways to grab onto these tough nuts and crack them without losing too much of your mental health over it. When you finally reach the game's original Stalingrad mission and see the map for the first time, you realize that it contains all of South Russia and that you'll have to follow the tracks of Field Marshal, the entire German 1942 Eastern Summer Campaign. What you don't get to realize immediately is that the fateful city on the Volga bearing Stalin's name is a big and disgustingly foul-smelling red herring, viciously intended to tear decisive victory right out of your hands. If you know anything about World War II, you'd expect to commit most of your forces and attention to Stalingrad. But no, it is relatively easy and the real challenge lies far to the south, in Grozny and Baku, which will force you to cover huge distances and greet you with unpleasantly strong defenses. But preparations first. You need a lot of tanks for this mission. The steppe is ideal for them, and surprisingly, you'll need them to storm Stalingrad, so buy up more if you haven't got enough. Artillery is indispensable as always. Infantry? You're getting enough Romanian Hungarian guys to die for you, and some of them are actually decent, so limit your own infantry contingent to a couple of top units. You'll need all the air force you've got, especially Strat bombers. The enemy will pester you with ships. Do not deploy any core units in Crimea. The auxiliaries are quite sufficient for taking it, and don't forget to bring them back into the fold as soon as they capture the peninsula, especially the Gustav gun, it'll be just right to poop a few Soviet passes down south. As you begin on your main front, push east everywhere. Krasnodar and Voronezh should fall pretty quickly, and as soon as you cross the Donets River, you're not getting any serious resistance up until Stalingrad proper. Taking which, I shit you not, needs 3 tanks and a couple of artillery units. The surroundings do look scary, but the AI is incredibly passive and will let you get away with more than it should. So, soften up the infantry, wipe it out, occupy the city with tanks, and you're set. Astrakhan takes another tank unit with air support to capture, so nothing to worry about either. All of this means that as soon as you get close to Stalingrad, you must start redeploying to the south and popping those scattered objectives like Mykop. Use the bejesus out of your trains. They're the only way to get your troops to Grozny quickly. Once you're there, in force and on time, you'll have to try hard to let that decisive victory slip out of your hands. In short, Stalingrad, bad. Trains, good. Is it the 1st of May, or an anniversary of the October Revolution? No. It sure feels like a Soviet holiday, because this scenario is a walk in the park with a piece of cake in each of your hands. They want you to kill 70 enemy units and not lose any objectives, in a huge city, with a big open field in front that the Germans have to cross, and no air combat at all. Once you recover from the shock of how suddenly obliging the game has become, let your old KV tank force loose, and deploy infantry and artillery to hold the line around the objectives. The growing no-go area is a nice touch, which you should exploit. As it advances, return the tanks back to reserve, and get more guards and katushas out. I've got no more tips for you, really. You've been given a treat. Enjoy it. If you ever thought that this game's developers were nice people, and maybe even your friends, this is where you're gonna have an awakening so rude, it'll ripple out through tectonic plates and make seismographs spout dirty words for days on end. Actually, the developers wanted to make you wanna die as you played these scenarios, and they really managed to create an authentic representation of what the Battle of Stalingrad really was. Unending and excruciating. Now available in the comfort of your own home. Remember that these missions will be a terrible ordeal no matter what tips I offer, but let's make them a few percent easier in your brain cells, shall we? General advice time. Don't throw out your Italian auxiliaries. They're weak, but they can help you hold the line. And they poke suppressed enemies pretty well. Don't shy away from elite reinforcing your core units. It's expensive, I know, but you will inevitably sustain big losses. And what we've got here are easily the hardest bunch of missions in the entire Eastern Grand Campaign. Don't hurry or stretch yourself. There's plenty of time to go around with, and traps are everywhere. But do field lots of artillery, cover your infantry with it wherever you go, do use your tanks to smash infantry outside city tiles, and use your infantry to blast tanks within city tiles. Do exploit the awful 1-hex sight radius of conscripts and SMG infantry for infiltration and luring them into defensive artillery fire. And do deploy a recon unit to sneak around and pick up as many flags lying out there as you can. Now onto the scenarios themselves. The storming Stalingrad mission is very much an embodiment of all my points so far. It tests your mettle, no matter how experienced you are, and there are no easy victory tips here. So let me place a few general brushstrokes here and there to at least get you started. Focus on your ground forces and buy up infantry and arty if necessary. Use both the southern and northern deployment areas, split about equally. This way you'll cover more ground and eventually these groups will meet in the middle to strike at the last objectives. Try not to lose your Italian troops. You'll get a sneak attack on your airfield on turn 8, and diverting your own people there is not a good idea. Expect counterattacks as you approach every objective. Some of them are protected by pillboxes and they are wide sight radius. Persevere. Stalingrad Docks. This is my favorite of the bunch, probably because many objectives are named after the real strongholds of the battle. It's definitely the easiest one, and it's a nice change of pace. What with the river and the task of blasting enemy transport ships? So rail your strategic bombers out of their hangars and overstrength them if you can. Because of coastal anti-air defenses, your window for sinking transports is very narrow, so you should go for one-shot kills. The T-34 factory is perhaps the hardest objective to take. Be prepared for a lot of T-34s counter-attacking there, unsurprisingly. A few ambushes are set up in the areas around the railway track, so be careful about rushing into the fog of war there. Finally, the troops stationed along the riverbank are passive for the most part, so don't waste your time clearing them out. Stalingrad Ruins. Your last hurrah in the city is more like the morning after a big party when you have to clean up the mess everywhere and kick out some of the rowdier guests that have stayed too long. While the mission takes a lot of time, the difficulty isn't legendary. Repel the attack around Betonne and Gumrak, use the Italians and some of your corps. There are no traps and this area will be quiet once you're done with it. However, the enemy will attempt two more strikes, from the north on turn 8 and from the southwest on turn 16. As soon as you fight the northern push-off, your main forces should rush southwest. That's where the hardest objectives are. Feel free to pick off some of the infantry in the east in the meantime, and gradually advance to the objective there. Remember to leave strong infantry units on objective hexes in areas that you otherwise abandon. Because on turn 22, all of the dormant enemies on the map will activate to test if you can survive a zombie apocalypse. Alright, to wrap this up, hey, what about the escape from Stalingrad mission? What about it?
No retreat!
Seriously though, despite the name, it's got almost no Stalingrad in it, and it's largely a bog-standard Eastern Front mission with you on the edge of a flat field and a crap ton of enemies in the middle. Anyway, thanks for watching, check out the description for links to replay files, and feel free to push all the right buttons in that general area to make me very happy.